Pennsylvania. And tonight my assistant is going to be my white museum ambassador. So for showmanship, the most important thing, the way you start off is you take your rabbit and you tuck them and you hold them like a football and you approach the table and you hold them. So if you look at how I'm holding him, I kind of take his head and I tuck it under my arm. And you always want to make sure you're supporting them. And when you tuck their head, it feels very natural to them and it's very comforting. So now I'm going to set my rabbit down. Then pose him. So he is a commercial body type. So when I pose him, I make sure his hind foot is aligned with the highest point of the body. Now I'm going to introduce myself and the rabbit. So I'd say, hi, my name is Emma Kennerknecht. I have been in the Flying for 4-H Club for 9 years, and this is my white New Zealand senior buck, Baxter. Now I explain how he's a sixth class. So sixth class means senior buck, senior doe, intermediate doe, junior doe. Now if you have a fourth class, you'd say that senior buck, senior doe, junior buck, junior doe. The reason why the meat breeds have our six classes rather than four is because they take longer to mature, so they have that intermediate range. So now I explain the body types and the corresponding breeds for the body types. So Baxter has a commercial body type. Does anybody else know another breed that might have a commercial body type? Go ahead. Yep, that's right. Okay. And the compact body type. Does anybody know a breed that has a compact body type? Yep. Cylindrical? Yep. Does anybody know a breed that has the high head mount body type? Yep. There's upright cylindrical. These would be the two new breeds. So does anybody know the two new breeds that are just recognized? Yep. There's semi-arch. Does anybody know a breed that has the semi-arch body type?
You were correct about upright cylindrical.
Yeah, do you know a breed that has the semi-arch? No? Go ahead. Yep. And does anybody know a breed that has the full arch body type? Yeah, you're right. Alright, so now we're going to move on to the ears. So the first thing you check for in the ears is the tattoo. And if you see, this is BAX. And whenever I do showmanship, I always show the judge the tattoo in the rabbit just to prove to him like what it is. And then in the right ear, you find that registration, which is the R of the circle around it. Which if you look in Baxter's ear, he does have that R of the circle, which means he's registered. In the ears, you go look for any ear mites, ear cankers, rips and tears, any missing portions of the ears. You can look for the proper ear carriage, which is erect, which means straight up. Does anybody know the other two types of ear carriage? Go ahead. Yep, there's one more. The other type of ear carriage is V-shaped. And you can also look for the proper fur coverage and thickness of the ears. Okay, so now we're going to flip over your rabbit. How I flip over my rabbit is I take my right hand, if you're right-handed, and I put my index finger between his two front ears, and I grab his ears and the scruff of his neck. And you always want to make sure you support their butt, because when you flip them, this arm holds the majority of the weight so it doesn't hurt them. And then you've successfully flipped your rabbit. And at any time during your presentation, if your rabbit flips over, Just stay calm and flip them back over again. All right, so now we're gonna move on to the eyes. In the eyes, you wanna look for his proper eye color. Does anybody know what Baxter's proper eye color would be? Go ahead. Yep, red or pink. In the eyes, you can look for any signs of conjunctivitis or BPI, which is basically just pink eye and around it. And then there's moon eye and mole eye. There's any blindness or blind spots. Any cloudiness of the eye. Now we're going to move on to the nose. In the nose, you can look for snuffles, which snuffles might sound cute, but it really isn't. Does anybody know a sign that the rabbit might show if it has snuffles? Yeah, weight discharge is what they typically have. Yeah, so the inside of their paws right here would be matted. And then in the nose, you can look for any nasal discharge, any foreign spots or covers, and any missing portions of the nose. Now I'm going to check the mouth. So the most important thing when you check the mouth is how you show the teeth. So you always want to come up top and show the teeth like this, because if you come from down below, they might try to bite you. So you always want to come from up top to show the teeth. Now in the mouth, you see four teeth. Does anybody know how many teeth a rabbit has? They actually have 28. So, a rabbit's teeth are like this. So their top teeth slightly overlap their bottom teeth. If their teeth are like this, that's simple malocclusion. And there are a few types of simple malocclusion, which would be peg teeth, budding teeth. And then if their malocclusion is really bad, their top teeth would go behind their bottom teeth. And it kind of look like this. And that would be called either wolf teeth or buck teeth also. Some other things you can look for in the mouth is any chipped or broken teeth, or missing teeth. There's also slobbers, which is when their chest will be all wet and their claws will be matted, which is caused by a chipped or broken tooth. And then you can also check to make sure your jawline is straight, which is kind of how you check your teeth. You just kind of feel, make sure everything feels right. Now I'm going to move on to the front legs. The first thing I'm going to check for is straightness. So how I do that is I take my hand and I just kind of push his leg up. You want to do that for both legs. Does anybody know one thing you look for in the front feet and legs when doing showmanship? Okay. Yep. So on their front feet, they should have four toes, four toenails, and then a dew claw. Does anybody know what his proper toenail color should be?
White.
Yep. And then you want to check for bone density, which is just check to make sure he has really nice strong bones, which Baxter has pretty strong bones. Look for any broken legs, broken toes. And then another thing is when you check their toenails, you press down on their foot pads and it extends all their toenails. So you want to look for any extra or missing toes or toenails, any mismatched toenails. One very important thing is to check their foot pads. That's something new they added onto the showmanship sheet. So always make sure you check their foot pads to make sure they're nice and covered. Now I'm going to move on to the chest and belly. Does anybody know what it's called when the rib cage is in the shape of an upside down V? Go ahead. What was it? Yep. And then in the stomach, does anybody know what it's called when a nursing doe has an infection of their mammary gland? Yep. And then in both the chest and belly, you want to look for any abscesses, tumors, abnormalities, or blemishes. And you can also check for warbles, which are clients. Now we're going to move on to the back feet and legs. So once again, we're going to check for straightness, which how I do this is I kind of grab his leg and just squeeze a little bit, and it extends both his legs. Does anybody know one thing that's different about the back feet than the front feet? Yep, no dewclaw. So on the back feet, they should have only four toes and four toenails, but no dewclaw. So in the back feet, you want to check for straightness of the legs, four toes and four toenails, and no dewclaw. Any broken legs or broken toes. Look for any extra missing toes or toenails. You can look for bear hops, which just goes along with checking the pads. And that's when they hop on the wire and the pads of their foot squares off and their foot becomes bare. And then you can also look for any sore hops, which starts out as bear hops and they continue to hop on the wire to develop a scab. Pigeon-toed is when his feet are pointing inward, and you can look for any splayed or sprouted legs, and that is when the muscling or tissue of the leg is misformed, and it causes to kind of like sprattle open. And you can look for any boat legs. Now I'm going to sex my rabbit. So how you sex your rabbit is if you see this little triangle of fur, you want to press down on that. And as you can barely clearly see, he's a buck. And since he is a, does anybody know what you check for in a buck? What was it? Yep. So intermediate and senior bucks should have two descended testicles. Now if he were a junior, he does not have to have both descended testicles, but he either has to have both of them or none if he were to only have one of these qualifications. And if he were a doe, you can look for hunchburn and head disease. Now I'm going to check the tail. In the tail, you can look for screw tail, dead tail, bob tail, flat tail, and no tail at all. You can look for color and straightness. Now, does anybody know which one I named is not a disqualification? So the only one that is not a disqualification is a dead tail. Now I'm going to flip my rabbit back over. I always make sure I close him up again. And now I'm going to go over the fur. So Baxter has normal flyback fur. And that's when you stroke from the tail to his head, and his fur almost immediately goes back into position. Now, there's also, does anybody know another breed that has flyback fur? Yep. And there's rollback fur, which is that's when you stroke from his tail to his head, and the fur just rolls back into position. Does anybody know a breed that has rollback fur? Does anybody know one that has the rollback fur? Yep, the Hallock does. So standing fur is when you stroke from the tail to the head and it stands straight up. Now it's a breed. There you go. Rexford. Does anybody know the two breeds that have Rexford?
Rex.
Yep. Who knows the two breeds that have Satin? Can anybody name one breed that has wool? Yep. And there is now the slow wool backer. Does anybody know the two breeds that have slow wool backer? Yep. And whenever you check for fur, you also want to check for the density, sheen, the luster, and texture of the fur. That's one I commonly miss when going through showmanship, so a way I try to help me remember it is I kind of incorporate it into the breeds. So your satins will have a lot of sheen, the Havanas have luster, the Rex have a lot of density, and the wool breeds have a lot of texture. And whenever you're looking at the fur too, you also want to look for some staining and the fur condition, which he's a little stained. And he's in fairly good condition right now. All right. Now we're going to move on to the judging comments. So one thing that I found that helps me with this is to find a rabbit that's not perfect, so you can really point out those flaws. So Baxter here, he's a little older, so he's got more flaws as he's gotten older. So if you look at Baxter, he is not nearly as full in the loin as he should be. So when judging the commercial breeds, you want them to look like a basketball. So from this angle, you want to be nice and full all the way around. And as you can see, he comes in a little bit right here. And you want your basketball to have some dents in it. So you want to be nice and full all the way around. Another thing with Baxter is if you look at him, he's really tall. He has a lot of depth. But when you look at him this way, he doesn't have as much width as he does depth. And you want your basketball to be a wall. So you want the width and depth to be balanced. Another really important thing when looking at the commercial rabbits is the firmness of flesh. So as Baxter has gotten older, he has lost the firmness of flesh. So when you touch them, that just really means you want them to feel like a brick. He has good shoulders and a good midsection. I'd like to see him be a little more filled out throughout his loin, the lower hind quarter. He rounds off well, and I'd like to see a little more width to balance with his neck. Now, one last thing that's very important for showmanship is your appearance. So, you can see in the pictures, I have two different ways that you can dress for showmanship. You can wear long pants and then the white shirt coat. And then there's also the black pants and the show shirt with an apron. Those are the two ways you can dress. And if you're a girl, you always want to have your hair up and you don't want your nails painted. Because you don't want it to distract from the appearance of the rabbit. And you don't want any dangly jewelry. And you don't want them chewing gum. And you don't want to have a hat on. You want to make sure you don't. That's the end of my demonstration. Do you have any questions?